guys, welcome back to the Dream Academia channel. My name is Shrimoy Mitra and we are back with an amazing crash course for the WBJE 2021. Due to the pandemic, the WBJE exam has been postponed. So, aap logon ko kuch waqt mila aapka preparation aur acha karne ke liye. So, let's not waste that time and work with full dedication. बहुत सारे लेक्चर्स आएंगे, सो इफ़ यू फॉलो ईच लेक्चर विथ सिंसियरिटी, आई एम श्योर दैट विल हेल्प यू एंड यू विल बी बेनिफिटेड फ्रॉम इट. सो लेट्स नॉट वेस्ट एनी मोर टाइम एंड स्टार्ट विथ आर टॉपिक टुडे. तो हमारा आज का टॉपिक है फॉर्मेशन ऑफ इमेज बाय प्लेन मिरर. तो हम देखेंगे कि आप कैसे न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व कर सकते हैं, कैसे आप क्वेश्चन सॉल्व कर सकते हैं विथ ऑल योर नॉलेज अबाउट दिस टॉपिक. तो इस तरह के कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम में एक बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ ये होता है कि आप कितनी जल्दी आंसर्स निकाल सकते हो विथ मोर एक्यूरेसी. देर इज़ दिस टाइम क्रंच एंड यू हैव टू सॉल्व मेनी क्वेश्चन विद इन दैट स्पेसिफाइड टाइम. सो इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू कैन मैनेज द टाइम वेल. सो देखते हैं पहला क्वेश्चन. वॉट इज़ इट? एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज मूविंग हॉराइजॉन्टली विद वेलोसिटी 10 मीटर पर सेकेंड टूवर्ड्स अ फिक्स प्लेन मिरर as shown in the figure. Find the image velocity. I have already drawn the diagram. Look at it. It is very simple. The velocity of that object is already given, which is moving towards the mirror, and the mirror is at rest. So we can easily use the formula, that is v of I is negative of v of O, or mod of vi is equal to mod of vo. This is one result that we already know. Now CA is the direction of the velocity of image, and we break that direction into components, break the velocity into its components, that is VI sin theta and VI cos theta. So what we have to do, we have to find out the velocity of the image with respect to mirror. We are finding here the velocity with respect to mirror because the mirror is at rest. So it can be written as VI cos theta I, since plus VI sin theta J, right? We just broke it into its components. Now, according to the Cartesian formula, we can easily put the values of VI here, which is 10, into cos theta. Cos theta is 60, so cos theta will be half. And since it is in the negative direction of I, so we will put minus I, plus 10 into root 3 by 2 J. Now just put the values and you will have the answer, which is the option number B. So moving on to the next question, it's an assertion reason type question. Is type question un logo ko bahut hi pasand hai and they repeat this question each year. This type of question, not this question, but this type of question is very one of their favorites. So what is the assertion? It is the plane mirror may form a real image, and the reason is the plane mirror forms virtual image if the object is real. So kya plane mirror form kar sakta hai real image? Yes, definitely yes. If the object is virtual, then the plane mirror may form a real image. And the reason forms virtual image if the object is real, this is the normal case. So obviously this is true. So assertion is correct, reason is correct. Now let's check if the reason is a correct explanation for assertion. So the option B should be correct. तो अगला सम देखते हैं, वो है एक रे. A ray of light is incident at 50 degree on the middle of one of the two plane mirrors arranged at an angle of 60 degree between them. The ray then touches the second mirror and get reflected back to the first mirror, making an angle of incidence off. So in this type of question, the diagram is very important. You have to understand the question and then draw the diagram. So I have already drawn the diagram. You can see the arrows are very important in the ray diagrams. Without arrow, they don't mean anything. So never forget the arrows. तो हमको यहाँ पर क्या निकालना है, हमको निकालना है द थीटा एंगल और बाकी की चीज़ इज गिवन. सो लेट्स सी इफ वी कैन सॉल्व दैट. सॉल्विंग दिस क्वेश्चन, दिस इज ये एक ज्योमेट्री का क्वेश्चन है, तो आप लोग सिर्फ ज्योमेट्री की अंडरस्टैंडिंग और उसका कंसेप्ट लगाकर ये सॉल्व कर सकते हैं. तो फर्स्ट वी हैव दिस रे एफ ए विच मेक्स एन एंगल ऑफ 50 डिग्री विद द मिरर ओ सी. सो इफ द एंगल 50 डिग्री इज गिवन द एंगल एफ ए ई, देन वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट ई ए बी, द एंगल ई ए बी मस्ट ऑल्सो बी 50 डिग्री. दिस एंगल शुड बी इक्वल टू दिस एंगल अकॉर्डिंग टू द मिरर, द लॉज ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन दैट इज आई is equal to r, angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection. From that we can also write that angle BAO is 90 minus 50, since AE is the normal to the mirror OC. So 90 minus 50, this angle should be 40 degree. We know that sum of the three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. From that we can find out the angle OBA, this angle. So what should it be? It should be 80 degree. Line BE is normal to the mirror OB. We can find out this angle, which should be equal to the angle FBE according to the laws of reflection. So this angle should be 90 minus 80, that is equals to 10 degree. Angle ABE is 10 degree. Similarly, angle FBE is also 10 degree. So the whole angle OBC, what should it be? It should be 80 plus 10 plus 10. What it is 100 degrees. So we have angle BOC which is 60 degree, angle OBC which is 100 degree. So we can easily find out angle alpha, right? So the angle, what should be the angle alpha? Angle alpha should be 180 minus 100 minus 60, right? So what should it be? 20 degree. Now since we have angle alpha already and we know angle DCO is 90 degrees, since it is normal to the mirror OC, we can easily find out angle theta, which is 90 minus 20, that is equals to 70 degrees. So do we have that option here? Let's see. Yes, we have that option here and answer C is correct. हमको और क्वेश्चंस जल्दी से जल्दी सॉल्व करना है, तो देख लेते हैं अगला सम. अ प्लेन मिरर इज मूविंग विद वेलोसिटी 4i प्लस 5j प्लस 8k. अ पॉइंट ऑब्जेक्ट इन द फ्रंट ऑफ द मिरर मूव्स विद अ वेलोसिटी 3i प्लस 4j प्लस 5k. हियर k इज अलोंग द नॉर्मल टू द प्लेन मिरर एंड फेसिंग टुवर्ड्स द ऑब्जेक्ट द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द इमेजेस. फ्रॉम द क्वेश्चन इट इज अंडरस्टैंडेबल दैट the velocity along the normal change, but velocity perpendicular to the normal remain constant. So I and jth component wo constant rahega, humko sirf aur sirf k component ke liye change dhoondna hai. So we can easily use this formula to find out for the kth component. For kth component we can use this formula, that is v image k can be written as 2vi minus vo for kth component only. Now put the values vi for the kth component. Vi it is 8k, so we can write 2 into 8, and for object it is 5k. So 2 into 8 minus 5, we should be 16 minus 5, that is 11. Now since I and jth component are constant, option A is correct. The next question says, two plane mirrors are parallel to each other and placed 20 cm apart. An object is kept in between them 15 cm from A out of the following, which point is image not formed in mirror A, distance measured from A? So I've already drawn the diagram. आप लोग देख सकते हैं कि object is placed 15 centimeter from the mirror A and the distance between the two mirrors is 20 centimeter. So if we denote XA as the image distance from A, image formed in A, and XB as image formed in B. For the first reflection of object O in mirror A, what should be the distance of image IA from A? Yes, it should be 15 centimeter. Similarly, the image distance IB from mirror B should be 5 centimeter. अब एक चीज होगा, हमारा जो IB जो इमेज है will now act as an object for the mirror A. So reflection will occur again. Since the mirrors are placed parallelly and the object is placed between them, there will be infinite number of reflection, that is infinite number of image. इसलिए हमको बहुत सारा images मिलेगा. For the second reflection, IB is the object. So what should be the image distance from A? Yes, it should be 5 plus 20. We have to add 20 to 5. So it should be 25. Similarly, when object is IA and the reflection is occurring on mirror B, we have to add 15 plus 20, which is 35. इस तरह हमको क्रिस-क्रॉस तरह से 20 add करते जाना है. And this series will continue up to infinite number of images. So what should be the next image in A? It should be 35 plus 20, which is 55. Similarly, the image in B will be 45. I think this will continue. Now, when we look at the option, image that is not formed in mirror A, 15 centimeter is formed, 55 centimeter is also formed, but 45 centimeter is formed in mirror B. So the answer should be 45 centimeter. So with this, we end today's lecture. I hope you got the hang of how to solve these type of questions, right? They are not very difficult. आपको सिर्फ और सिर्फ visualize करना है और उसको break down करना है. You have to read each word of the question and break down करना है और उसको एक diagram में draw करना है. After that, the solving of the question becomes very easy. So I hope you can solve more and more questions by your own. And thank you for watching our lecture, and hope you will find the upcoming lectures interesting. Best of luck for your exam. Goodbye.